Well, we're at the end of this session today at MMA. Half of us are thinking, "Ghar pe kaise pahunchenge? Mumbai ka traffic hai." So, give me 15 minutes. I'm sure you won't be disappointed. If you are involved in any way in creating, building, or managing ads that help consumers think, feel, cry, laugh, smile, and more importantly, buy, then this session is for you. If you are directly or indirectly responsible for a brand or a category's growth, then this session is for you. You see, we at Kantar Millward Brown have been extremely lucky. We've spent close to 10 years here in the Indian industry, the advertising industry, and what it allowed us to do is it has allowed us to measure close to 15,000 creatives before they've actually gone live, 200 digital or mobile campaigns, and more than 100 cross-media or multimedia campaigns. So what it does is it gives us an incredible backseat view into how the advertising industry is currently evolving. And what it also does is that it allows us an access to metrics that are not publicly available, openly available, but it actually is a great precursor on where the industry is actually moving. And that's what we're about to talk to you about here. So we all know that television is the most dominant media in the country today, right? There's no debate around that point. But do we also know that digital is actually able to drive about 7 to 8% of incremental reach over and above television? So a lot of people actually do not consume television at all these days, right? But if that metric does not astound you, the main impact, the major impact that digital is able to drive is towards the brand metrics. So if you look at the charts over the pie charts on your screens, you will see that during 2012 to 2015, where we could see the blue part of that pie graph, which represents television, was the most dominant media. The more recent campaigns that we've evaluated seems to suggest that television has actually given in to digital, and digital has actually eaten up the pie. So before we jump onto the guns to say that, okay, here's what I do, I take my television dollars and put it on digital, we got to talk about the dark side of it. There's obviously viability concerns. Wayne has spoken about it, so I won't do that again. But there's also a case of where different media, the different audiences, I beg your pardon, respond or resonate to different media in a very different manner. Gen X, for example, the older audiences tend to resonate to traditional media much better than the digital media. And there's also a fact that 22% of your media buys in India today are wasted due to inefficient allocations. So when Vishikh and I were sitting down and thinking about what are we going to present at MMA this year, I think we unanimously agreed that we're going to empower you guys. We're going to empower you guys to stop thinking what you're going to do on mobile, what your brand is going to do on mobile, and instead swap that and start thinking on what mobile can actually do for your brand. So very quickly, 4 quick recommendations that we're going to give to you. And we're also going to look at Smarties 2018, which is just about to begin after this session, and look at how the trends that we're observing in Smarties year on year kind of resonates and coincides with the recommendations that we're about to call out. Yep. So very quickly, going multimedia is the first bit. So, you know, television is not the holy grail anymore. Mobile isn't either. There are a lot of studies actually tend to indicate that multimedia channels are much more efficient these days. And here's a study done by the Advertising Research Foundation, which seems to suggest that if you have about 5 channels on your media plan, you tend to have about 35% incremental impact compared to a media plan which has only 1 channel involved. And if you look at Smarties, so last year we had about 64% of winning campaigns that used mobile as the only channel. And what has happened this year? 45%. So it seems to suggest that more and more winning campaigns in Smarties are actually adopting a multi-channel strategy. Moving on to going contextual. You see, if you start thinking about how content is being consumed today, on television, it is a more lean-back kind of a content consumption. When you are leaning back, you are consuming the content. But with the evolution of new devices, the consumption has become more towards connectivity or productivity side of things, where you're actually trying to communicate with a friend, chat with a friend, look at your emails, or actually trying to search for some kind of information. And how we as marketers have actually responded to it by actually reducing the size of the creative. And obviously, it limits the way in which we are able to communicate with our audiences and how much we are able to actually even communicate. That's where made-for-web conversations are actually trending in today. Our cross-media campaigns that we've evaluated seems to suggest that made-for-web ads tend to actually drive much more impact compared to a simply repurposed television ad. And not only that, the fact that an integrated campaign, so an integrated campaign is something where you can think of a repurposed television ad, can actually drive much more impact than a non-integrated campaign. So a non-integrated campaign is a brand that is actually omnipresent across with various different messaging coming out on different media channels. But if you want to drive even more impact, the better impact, we're recommending that you actually customize the user experience to the platforms that you are advertising on. So native advertising is a great example of exactly that, and content marketing is no different. So sometime last year, we were approached by a huge auto car maker who had actually integrated their car as a part of a webisode. So it was a webisode on a group of friends traveling from one place to another. And the car maker had actually integrated within that episode where the traveling was actually happening through in that particular vehicle. And there were great shots around it. So when we ran a brand lift around it, we found out that although that campaign did not do as well on building the salience bit for that brand, which they could have anyways done by using the other mass media channels, they actually scored very well on our norm scores for driving the lower purchase funnel. And again, when we look at Smarties, again, for 2017, we saw about 6% of the winning campaigns had deployed a native ad format compared to this year, where we saw that an astounding 34% winning campaigns had deployed a native ad format. Which brings us to the next point, which is forming a lasting impression. And I'd request my colleague, Vishikh, to take on this further.
Thanks, Meheer. The choice of vehicle or the right vehicle is just half the job done for the marketer. What the brand has to say, how it's going to say, create a lasting impression is an equally important job. Our next section is more about that. This comes from what Meheer was talking earlier as well. We've studied creative advertising for more than 15,000 ads over the last 10 odd years. We perhaps have unparalleled expertise and understanding of how creative works and how it's evolving itself into the digital and what elements of digital bring to the complexities. So we all know that in the mobile world, in the digital world, advertising is an irritant. I don't want to watch it. I'm using all kinds of mechanisms to avoid it. Over and above, we've got the 5-second challenge. If the marketer is not able to attract his attention, not get their engagement or say the message in 5 seconds, the money is entirely wasted. And therefore, there is a lot more pressure in terms of a creative and the communication and the story that the brand needs to tell. We're presenting you here a small case study just to make and elaborate the point in terms of how we need to adapt for the new digital world. If you could play the first ad, please.
Shortcut mat pehno. Sleeveless mein mat aao. Ooh, backless. Arre, par pura bhi mat dhako. Hello, kamar mat dikhao. Your cleavage is showing. Suno, ise dupatta pehnao. Sorry, dude, auntie wale kapde kyun pehen liye? औरत सोरा बनेगी के चोरी. Don't invite attention. Why do you want attention? कितनी revealing dress है. ज्यादा बनो मत, ज्यादा तनो मत. Okay.
Confident in your skin. लोग तो कुछ न कुछ कहेंगे ही.
A powerful ad, fully charged, highly emotional, making a very strong statement against the samaj ke thekedars. Slice of life elements in each of them, a montage of different shots there. Let's just contrast it with the other ad. If you could just play the other ad, please.
Mm-hmm. Shh. 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 Oh, yeah,
believes happy, healthy babies need mama and papa.
Papa. Papa.
Mama.
Papa.
Mama.
Another slice of life depiction, using again very strong emotions, and a very, very clear message of it takes two to tango. Let's see how they performed.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. So both the ads did very well as far as the 5-second challenge was concerned. They could sustain the consumer interest for a fairly long time. Pampers did a little better. But when you look at the brand metrics, Parachute, though, had a lot of potential, did not do as well. Very similar in their execution, very similar in their style, yet one does better than the other. And that's what started us thinking is, how do we explain this? Largely, they were very, very, you know, talking almost a similar kind of language all through. Let me try to explain it to you with the 4 or 8 golden rules that we have around digital advertising in that space and how best each of them have utilized, and then I think we'll be able to appreciate why one did better than the other. So first and foremost, it has to develop an emotional response. Well, both the ads did pretty well there, so we'll give it a tick. It needs to tell a story. Now, the Pampers ad was very, very clear. From the first screen, we knew where it was headed. There was a progression, be it in day parts, starting with the night to the morning to the later evening, or be it in terms of the progression of the age of the kid. While in Parachute, there were discrete scenes. They were not so connected well to each other. And that's where Parachute did not do as well. It can be argued that Parachute ad actually did not need music because it was taking a pretty aggressive stance. But on the other hand, Pampers had a very soft, nice, appeasing music and it was running through. Humor has been an integral part of the advertising. It has been able to create the cut-throughs far better, whether it was in traditional media, equally works well in the digital, is what we've seen. None of the actually ads use that particular element in this, so we will not comment on that. On getting the length right, Parachute, we believe, was a little too long to sustain the intrigue that it was creating through its, you know, aggressive posturing that it was taking. While on the other hand, Pampers was absolutely right, it was holding all the attention. More importantly, on branding is where Parachute falters fair enough, because the brand almost comes towards the very end of the, you know, of the ad. And even the whole story is missing the category codes. It's not very clear what the, you know, the marketer or the brand is trying to convey till you have come to the point. And the whole confident in my skin and layering it to the message is a very layered message. It's not simple, it's not direct, so it doesn't come too easily to the consumers. And therefore, the brand did not end up being the hero. Eventually, that's where it lost out on branding. Again, the aggressive posturing perhaps diluted the positive impressions about the brand, and therefore it overloaded the minds of the consumers for Parachute. And if we were to skip the ad right in the beginning for Parachute, or even after 10 seconds, or even after 30 seconds, it's a pretty long ad, about almost a minute and a half, we would not have known what we were talking about, what was the category, what was the brand. We had absolutely no idea what was, you know, what was going there, and perhaps we would have assumed it was a social messaging ad. While for Pampers, even if you would have skipped in 3 seconds, the messages were clear. The father has an equal role, what the category is, what the brand Pampers is all about, and the very first moments where it's itself creating the emotive response. So it had done its job in 3 seconds, not even 5 seconds. My time's over, but can I take another 5 minutes? So it's quite clear why Pampers did well. I don't think we need to delve anymore. Coming on to the last story, and this comes from our heart. Every campaign that we make is against certain brand objectives. And we are in an era where we are evolving very, very quickly, very, very fast. We are learning, and we need to keep applying that learning. But if you're not measuring our results in a correct way, then we are not learning the right way, and then therefore the evolution of the market itself, of all of us who's learning from each other, is getting hampered if you're not measuring it right. Digital is an arena where lots of data is available. Digital also an arena where a lot of metrics are available to measure. But are those the right metrics? Perhaps for a performance-based advertising, but most of our campaigns are not necessarily performance. You want the brand to build its equity. You want the brand to sell it. And most of these measures, one example here, which is the click-through rates, actually do not correlate with brand performance metrics. Absolutely negligible correlations in the 3 examples that we've given there. So it's what, therefore, are the right metrics? I think the right metrics come from the objectives of the campaign. If the objective of the campaign is to build equity, then it's brand-related. If it's awareness, then it's awareness-related. If it's about sales, then it's about sales. If it's both, yeah, it's you got to measure what's the impact on brand and what's the impact on the sales. So it has to be the mix of it. We also looked at Smarties to see what was happening. So the movement seems to be in the right direction. Last year, only 38% had measured it correctly when they were pitching it. This year, 45%. But I think this movement is too slow and too limiting. I think we need to evolve that. We need to get those measurements right because we all need to learn. We are in that space where things are changing very fast. That's all we had. So just a quick recap of what we are saying. Go multimedia. One media is not sufficient. Be it mobile, be it TV. Add TV to mobile, add movie, mobile to TV, at least bare minimum, get 1+1. Be contextual. There are lots of innovations happening in the mobile space. Use those, apply those intelligently. Form a lasting impression, far more important for the brand than anything else. I need to leave the consumers thinking good about my brand. I want my consumers to come and buy me. So form a lasting impression, obviously measure it right, because only then we'll be able to collectively learn. Thank you.